after payment of ransom and release of the victims, the police are able to arrest, to go and catch the kidnappers. And as we speak now, I know that the police has in custody not less than 800 of suspected kidnappers. So the system is working. Perhaps it's not as most people want it, but are we able to apprehend them as they do these things? I think that it's something that our police should be commended for doing.
Commended?
Commended. And this is, as I said, in terms of arrest of kidnappers.
Well, let's see how,
90% of the cases.
I'm sure that Nigerians would definitely have their own, because a lot of kidnap cases that go on unreported. I mean, a lot of them do not even have the confidence in the police and the justice.
But then is that where you have a problem?
If they do that, they're doing it for the sake of, to fulfill all righteousness, as it were. But let's quickly talk about this situation in Borno State only recently, just last week. I think we understood that, there was an accidental bombing of a community in Ran. And right now, people are asking that compensation be paid the victims. Yes, the federal government has come out to say that they're sorry, and the president has given instructions that this must never happen again. The military owned up to it. But then a lot of people believe that that is not sufficient, and that the people who were affected by that bombing, compensation needs to be paid to them. Is this something the federal government is considering?
Mopay is a war situation. And it's tragic, as the president said, it's unfortunate that this has happened. It should not have happened. And we hope that the investigation will uncover why it happened, so that measures are taken in the future to ensure that this does not happen. And I think we've done so far, fairly well coming this far, considering that this is a five-year-old war, and this is the first time we're having this kind of incident. It's tragic and unfortunate. We regret it. Such accidents also do happen in war situations, in Iraq, in Syria, in Afghanistan. There have always been civilian casualties, collateral damage. Again, they may not be in the numbers we just heard from Borno. It's shocking. However, I think that we will wait for the panel of investigation to conclude. But I don't think it is the norm in military history anywhere that compensations are paid for civilian casualties in war situations. But historians here should help us to do a check. I have my doubts.
Well, we can start to set a precedent. If we feel sorry enough that these people were supposed to be receiving protection from the state in their community, because you say it's not an intelligence, it's an unofficial camp, put together by the community themselves, and they were there, and over 50 of them. I'm very careful with figures right now.
Yeah, well,
at last time I think we had close to 100 people lost their lives in that bombing.
As a matter of fact, it's more than that as we speak now, because yes, people are abandoning numbers.
Yes,
the people who bury, the local authorities should be believed, and I think that the numbers that are coming out of Borno are the ones.
What are the numbers that you have?
By Saturday, they were talking about 236.
That's a lot of people.
It is.
But who then, lost their lives.
Yes. It's, as I said, it's very tragic and it's unfortunate. But you know that...
Can we just say that is collateral damage?
It didn't just happen because credible intelligence had been received. Boko Haram fighters had moved, and they had been picked by systems, satellite, and all of that, and they had gone to that community, and when the raids were, the air raid was planned, the Boko Haram elements pulled out, and you can see that 2 days after that incident, they came back again in the hope that they probably can also mislead the military into the same mistakes.
We hope. I mean, the military has said they're going to do an investigative hearing into this. There will be an investigation launched.
Yes.
Do you think that it's going to be public?
Well, I don't know how they will do it, but I know that as many as 4 investigations are ongoing.
Are ongoing.
Concurrently.
Well, will any of them, will the findings be made public?
The government is an accountable government. The government has no reason to keep this away from the Nigerian public. Will there be public hearings like as you do in the parliament? I don't know whether that is in the acceptable to military traditions. However, I think that this is so painful. So
if you say that, you know, if we're talking about precedents, for instance, in that regard, at least we have the precedent set by Israel in that regard, where there are public hearings even in the military. And this, because the military is funded by taxpayers' money, it's the security of lives and property we're talking about. We're talking about an entire community that was almost, you know, burnt out. Over 200 people by the figures that you yourself have admitted. And that's a lot of numbers. If something that Nigerians should be concerned about, if the military has to be open about it, then they have to be open about it. Military tradition, there is a precedent for that. Especially now that we're talking about lives.
Exactly. Well, you know, if you
want... And credibility.
If the military, they have their own traditions. I don't know about it. I don't know how they do these things. If you ask me from where I'm coming from, my background of the media, I'm all for full disclosure. However, if it compromises national security, then that shouldn't happen. So we hope that... if there is blame, if anybody is blameworthy, that blame should be pinned on them and then appropriate retribution, punishment be meted out on who they are. Will there be compensation? The panel would not be preempted by anyone here. We hope that when they come out with their recommendations, you are asking for precedent to be set. If they're able to persuade the Nigerian government.
I'm saying that because you say that as you can't find any president you don't know about anywhere in the world where that has happened.
Yeah, civilian
so
casualties.
I haven't also done my research on that to know if there's any, you know, president in that regard. But I'm saying that in that regard, if there is none at all in the world, it should not be such a difficult situation for the federal government to set a precedent in
well,
that regard.
Well, somebody needs to make that convincing
because
case.
We don't even know if, you know, we've heard that over 200 people have been killed in any community before now in all of the situations that were cited outside of this country.
No. I believe that if you look around, you would see that a lot of these things have happened, in many countries. Go back to the World War. It has always accompanied what they call collateral damage. Has always accompanied, you know, air attacks and wars. Do they pay compensation? We haven't seen that anywhere.
Why has it been difficult, for instance, for the president to pay visits to any of the places that have been affected by this problems? Is it Southern Kaduna? Is it even Borno? Yes, it's visited men on the front, but in terms of the communities themselves, we've not seen the president physically going there to, you know, pay a, you know, sympathy visit to those people who have been affected by the crisis.
It depends on what you want, what you are. If I come from Kachia or one of these communities which have been given a battalion of the military, or rather have a battalion or squadron of armed mobile policemen, protective policemen around me, then the siren blowing convoy of the president who comes in and moves out. I'm not saying that the president doesn't feel this pain. He's a father, he's a grandfather, he has family, and he has his heart on all of these matters. What happens is that when he's represented by competent elements around him, they report to him adequately on things that need to be done. And I think that people should decide what they themselves want. We had had governments that had played on rhetoric most of the time and give us that as substitute for action. The president would rather speak through his actions than being sentimental about some of these things.
Well, Garba Shehu, we have to thank you for coming on Sunrise Daily. He's a senior special assistant to the president on media.